yet. They're installed, ready to go, but I haven't actually. I picked up my summer car just as a last minute thing, just at the end of the sale. Right, good morning, driver. Today you're in charge of the first rail motor service of the day. Pull forward to the head shunt. I'm going to disconnect the rail drive, actually. I love this thing. It's fantastic. Let me turn the rail driver off because I don't think it works with this loco. Plans on playing Jalopy? Yeah, I am going to. I'm going to add that to my list. What I am going to try and do is see if I can actually figure out. I've got managed to get the car, and it looks like I've got to drive somewhere, but I can't figure out. I get lost. So, but I've only spent barely 2 hours on it so far, so I still need to put a bit more effort into it. I'm enjoying it, though. Just keep getting interrupted with worky things. Okay, what's next? We're going to reverse, change that switch, back into the platform. Notice the gear changes on this one as well. Which is unusual, because it means that the author has actually animated this loco, or this unit. That load of gears, normally you'd animate once and that's bad enough. But he's animated it like 5 times for each of the different linkage settings. Right, so 429. I might not be able to fire this one from here. Oops. In this case, I need to remember how to fire it. Right, we've got coal mask on. That's better. That's going down. That's going up. Open the doors. Put the linkage back into forwards. Did I spot a red signal? I have to admit, I must admit, I wasn't looking. Was there a signal there? There was one there, wasn't there? Never mind. Such a futuristic train. It's the future, I tell you. I appear to have the right light to go out, though. So it can't have been that bad. I've got the signal to go out. Someone go and have a look at the VOD and find out. I'm trying to find the ideal fire mass at the moment. Right, next stop, exit St. Thomas. Oh, I wonder if this has got auto fireman on it or something. Yeah, I think this has got an auto fireman on it. I might be doing something I don't even need to do. How do you determine the ideal fire mass? You look at the steam generation rate while you're coaling up. And as you coal up, you'll see title's covering up the uptime. Oh, so it is. As you coal up and increase the fire mass, the steam generation rate will go up. Once you hit the ideal fire mass, it will come back down again quite sharply. So just watch for the steam generation rate to suddenly start dropping. And when it does, that means it's time to stop coaling, and you've found roughly the ideal fire mass. Is it possible to drive the power bogey? Yes, it is. It's a separate loco, which is literally just this boiler here. Exit St. Thomas down platform is first. See you later, Cameras Gaming. Yeah, it's because trackside simulation. That's because the FEF implements its own auto fireman, and the two conflict with each other. Ed, alternatively ask Ed to look at the simulation file. Ed, can you look in the simulation file, please? Next stop, Exminster. Signal, good to go. I've got to remember to shut the power off before we move the reverser. Exminster is next. Is it possible to determine the ideal fire mass without the F5 overlay? You can open the engine simulation file up, and you can go and actually just read the ideal fire mass out of the fire simulation. The only thing I can assume, GWR, is you've missed something. What do we got? 3.3 miles. Worried you changed too much. Well, you could have done actually. It's possible without looking at it. How fast are we doing? 40 miles an hour. Going to get much faster than this 40, though, I don't think. Miles. Yeah, they're not very quick. By trees. See you later, Ninja Joker. Are these sounds recorded from a real Railmotor? I don't know what the source of these sounds is. That you would need to ask Karma99 about when he next pops in. Normally tier 17 on the same SSD in your Windows, you move it to a second SSD and become very laggy. That I've no idea, Gouge. I don't have a clue why that would be. Certainly. I mean, I don't run it on other machines. I don't run it on the same machine as my boot disk, and it's not had a problem. That's very odd. Kind of give downloadable project files and HTML pop-ups. I'll see what I can sort out. Hey Dixon8037. How are you? Mr. Down platform coming up ahead. See you later, Chris. Thanks for stopping in. That's a good possibility, Haddock. Yeah, I was running the passenger view earlier on. Let me just get stopped. Right. Get a bit of air in the cab now. While we're stopped, let's get some air in the cab. Passenger view is here. Right, next stop is Starcross. That's 3.7 miles. Getting a track stop bin error with your scenario you're making. Is it a career scenario? I'm guessing it is a career scenario. You got bubblegum flavour ice lolly? Share. Well, I actually don't. I'm not that bothered about bubblegum flavour. Ooh, gunpowder van. Track stop bin coming up. When that comes up, it means it doesn't like something about the scenario. I mean, I would try getting rid of the MD5 files in the scenario folder, doing a refresh on the timetable view, taking something and moving it, flipping it back, and then try pressing F2 to save it, and see if that does anything. Sort of a little bit of voodoo, really, but. One of the jobs I got done, by the way, is over the holiday, is I got the Children in Need stream pushed across to YouTube. So that one will be coming up at some point soon. Two and a half miles. I haven't seen Rogue One yet, it's on my list I'd like to see, but we'll see when I get the chance to go to the cinema. I did see Passengers, which I enjoyed. Oscar, no, it'll be Euro. I've got a really bad Irish accent, I wasn't even intending to put an Irish accent on. Oh yeah, no, I want to see it, but I don't get a lot of opportunity to go to the cinema, so more often than not it has to wait until it comes on front row on Virgin. 1.5 miles. Realised I should put some water in. We almost had an epic fail. ETS2 doesn't have Priuses driving around you can ram into. I consider that a good thing. Don't want to ram into Prius. Did I download Pro Mods for the server stack? No, I didn't get 215. So I should be carrying on with just the Ipswich, the normal one with France DLC. That hissing sound is the water injector. A red light up there. I like the new toll booths as well, Moggy. Not so much the ones that aren't big enough for a truck to go through. What's occurring? Why have I got a red? For no good reason. No, I've vaguely heard about what's happened to Pro Mods, so I don't know the detail about it. Gather they got hacked, but I don't know. But presumably they haven't been able to get the site back up again, given the way people are talking. Crazy Dan, just look at any dovetail ones, pretty much. Oh, the ProMod site is back up, okay. Air in. Next stop is Dawlish Warren. Signalman burned his timetable. Well, a good thing it is too. It's 63 on the water now. Oh, I see. The fireman thinks I've got enough. Miles an hour. I seem to have overridden my desire to put a hole in the fire as well. Where are we going to? Dawlish Warren? Dawlish Down and Teignmouth. Custom PC Gamer Train Sim World will be out on Steam, and it'll be out sort of early this year. Toolmine hackers completely wrecked ProMod site, deleting files, etc. ProMod resorted to using a backup to get it back online, then it got hit again. Wow. Dan Demand, will this be going up on Twitch or YouTube? Well, I mean, all the videos are always on Twitch. And then some of them, this probably will be one of them, will go up onto YouTube. Electric Trains coaches, looking rather splendid. Does this train have wipers? It does. It's a hand cranky wiper. Complete the sound effects. Oi, David. Oi, what are you saying? What are you saying? Dawlish Warren coming up. I've been having to think about, by the way, and I think that I might be able to make it to where we can do a Twitch Plays One House Model Railway. As long as it's really, really carefully choreographed. And then we could have a challenge for... So effectively, what I'm thinking is people would type a command in to request control, and then the computer would randomly pick someone and give them, say, 2, 3, 4 minutes of dedicated control where just they are driving one train round and round, because it's a loop, so it doesn't matter. And it doesn't let them go backwards, and it doesn't let them go too fast. So it wouldn't actually cause any damage. So they'd be able to drive the train, and then we can have a challenge where they try and stop closest to a particular signal, or so, you know, at the end of Kimberley Station or something, and see who can get the closest to stopping correctly. Hey, it's Rubku! Doors are open. Next stop is Dawlish. What does what road sign say? Don't know what red sign you mean. Oh, this one. Bathing dangerous when red flag is flying. Next is Dawlish down 1.57. You want to see the door animation? Or do you mean the passenger doors? I'll show those when we get the next one. Welcome to all the Room Cruise viewers. Ronick! I missed your cheer. One bit cheer. GG. Well, you're easily confused. The thing is, one bit is 1 cent, Chasm. They're already going to be running about sort of 12 to 30 seconds behind, so they'll need a couple of laps to sort of figure out where they are and then get an idea. And then they'll have to try and guess when they try and stop the train. I think it'd be interesting to see. Oh, Riku, no, I haven't tried that yet, actually. I totally forgot about that. I got the code, I saw it, and then completely forgot about it. Well, Motor more is retardiest than a DeLorean, yeah, really. You need horn control. Nimmy boy, what am I driving? GWR, this is the steam rail motor. Yeah, thank you, Ronald Gaming. Way too slow. Way too slow. That'll do. Door open. Didn't I show you the door animations? Let's do that now. Next stop is Teignmouth. Trick is, I can't fire the thing unless we're stopped. I remember now, you can't fire this unless it's stopped. You can put water in, but you can't put coal in. David, yeah, there's locos with all sorts of sound stuff on it. I'll probably make sure it's one of the locos that's all tricked out with sound that we do. Although the only really one that you'd actually pick up on stream, I think, is the horn. There's lots of little clanks and so forth, but... getting any water in. Alright, it's got a bit of coal in, let's get going. Any water in. We appear to be throwing the water out the bottom, but we can't actually get it to go into the boiler. Oh, we're going to run out of boiler water here. Well, we've got 2.5 miles to do, and I can't put water in. See there, Ennis on him. I can't put water in. I've almost got nothing left in the tank now. I didn't have any problem putting water in earlier on. Partially opening the steam valve. Doesn't seem to be making any difference. the exhaust is going down. Live's not doing anything either. I tried adjusting the flow. I've only got binary control over that one. And the bottom one doesn't seem to be doing anything different depending on what it's set to. No, that's it, folks. I think we're about dead on this one. No, I'm using the live injector as well. What are we down to? 1.8 miles. Drive from the back cab, yeah. It's not actually as silly as it sounds, because it would go all the way, except we've only got 4 gallons left in there, so. How much water left in the boiler? 0.17. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get up a bit of speed. I'm just going to ease back off on the regulator, and because I think we explode at 0.1. 1.4. Yeah, baked bean kid, that's what I was doing. It already filled up once, filled up beautifully, and then just stopped. Not going to blow off, boiler pressure is too low. Yeah, all that water and none of it for the boiler. One mile to go. Less than a mile to go now, folks. Yeah, I'll mention it to Pete and get him to watch the video and he'll tell me what I did wrong. Don't the injectors fail to pick up? Oh, it could be, David. It could be. Yeah, I did. I have let the boiler pressure get, the fire mass get too low. That could be it. Because I didn't realise you could only fire it when you're stopped. So I've been sitting there thinking, oh, well, it's a, so let's, no, I can't. I've got no water to inject now. So really all I have got is the coasting. Oh, it's on the HUD. Let's give it another one last JF speed. Ronak, thank you very much for the other cheer. Much appreciated. Thank you. power. So it's like Apollo 13 attempting re-entry. Yeah, really. 0.4 of a mile to go, 20 miles an hour. We'll be fine. This should be fine. You wouldn't put seawater in there anyway, because that would cause all sorts of other problems. You need, as it, all the salt in there. Yeah, 100.7 by one, yeah. Fill up the jar with one cheers. You go for it. The thing I like about the cheers is because they you can spend $1.40, get 100 cheers, and then just issue them out in little tiny bits. .17. Leave it for the next driver to sort out. That was the general idea, FabDiva, yeah. Oh, we might not make it. Come on. Come on. Do it. Do it. Do it. 0.1. Can see the platform. Why not one more for today? Thank you, Ronak. Yeah, the Thomas the Tank Engine episode where Thomas had fish in the tanks. Yeah, really. Come on! I don't have the brakes on their own running, Simon. You should know that. Brake pressure is at 25, so they're off. Pee in the boiler. Right, we could get off here, folks. Oh, we're at 0.1, so that we could lose at any minute now the game's going to end. Oh, we have actually made it. This is close enough for me. Right. Everybody off! Get off! Yes! Yeah! That was good. I enjoyed that, actually. Right. You thought the game ended at 05? Oh, I thought it was 0.1. Right. Where you discover a hidden instruction and go, no! Right, it's time to restart the game again. Yes, you're right, David. I think it probably is failing to lift because the boiler pressure went down too far. That makes perfect sense. I'll double check with Pete to make sure that's right, but root of that was, of course, again, that I'd forgotten that you have to stop to be able to fire it. So I should have